Good morning, students. Welcome to today's session. I hope every one of you understood what and all we have seen so far in the last class. So here, once again, we have to recap all the things here. So the statistics divided into two sections. So one is nothing but calculation part, and another one graphical representation. That calculation part is nothing but in that we have seen all the types of datas. And how to find out the measures of central tendencies for different types of data, and how can you find out mean, median, mode directly with the help of the formula directly, and how to find out the missing frequency for mean, median, and mode. So everything we have seen in the first section, and I hope you have completed your exercises also. So next section is nothing but graphical representation, right? So graphical representation, in this graphical representation only two types available, two types of graphs are available here. Okay, so they are less than ogive and more than ogive, so both are called ogive curves. So in that two types are there, less than and also more than. So the purpose of drawing ogive curve is nothing but I can find out median value directly from the graph itself without any calculation. And one more thing you can keep it in your mind. So finding mode or median or mean value through the formula is the accurate one, right? And in the similar way, finding mean, mode, median through the graphical, that is through the graph, through the visualization, is nothing but approximate one only. So here we are going to find out median only through the ogive curves, right? And this one also an approximate value than your calculation, right? So here we are going to see one by one now. So first one is nothing but less than ogive. So draw less than and more than ogives to the following data. So the following data is continuous data. We are going to find out, or we are going to draw less than and more than ogive to the given data, right? So let us see how to draw.
Right, now we are going to draw less than and also more than ogive for the given data. So here in the solution you have to create a table like this. So the application of ogive for the given for finding the median value only. In median we need one important column, that is cumulative frequency. So the first two columns are the data, and the third column just write the cumulative frequency. So here 2, and here these two things, and here 22, then 46, 84, 100. You already know how to find out the cumulative frequency. So next two we are going to write less than information. So less than. So look at the path over here. So the left hand side is nothing but your lower limit of the transfer curve, and right hand side is nothing but upper limit of the transfer curve. So here less than, the word less than is nothing but that related to your transfer curve only. So less than your upper limit, right? So the less than is there means here you should fill up the upper limit of the here. Okay, so the upper limit of the first interval 55, and the second interval 60, 65, 70, 75, and 80. So these are the numbers in less than column, right? So what is the meaning of this? Less than 55, so less than 60, less than 65, less than 70, that is the meaning here. So next we are going to write the respective x1 and y value, that is that point we are going to plot in the graph. Okay, so here x1 is nothing but your less than value is nothing but x, and your cumulative frequency is nothing but 1. So that's all. So write with a point here. So 55 comma 2. Don't write up here 2 and here 2, so this is 55, right? So this less than column is x, and this cumulative frequency y. So next one, 60 comma 10. Then 65 comma 42, and 70 comma 46, and 75 comma 84, then 80 comma 100. So these are the points for less than ogive. So we are going to plot this point only on the graph for getting less than OG, right? So next in the same table, I'm going to fill up the more than table here, right? So more than means you can fill up the
So here for more than frequency, you can fill up the lower limit. Okay.
5, 70 and 75. And here also cumulative frequency all will be, but it is not the same cumulative frequency. So for more than 5, you have to fill up the cumulative frequency from down to top. That is bottom to up. Okay. So here the frequency all will be, right? So just here. Enter the cumulative frequency from top to bottom. Okay, sorry, from bottom to top. Right? So it is less than means, and this is usual cumulative frequency. It is top to bottom of the pad. And for more than frequency, the cumulative frequency of the pad is from bottom to top. So write the last number as this, that is 60. And then add like this. Okay, so this number and this number is plus here. So 38 plus 16. So 54. And then 24 plus 54, so 78. Then 12 plus 78 plus 90, and 90 plus 8, 98, and 98 plus 2, 100. So, however, the maximum cumulative frequency will be 100. Okay, and here the point. So, more than point. So, more than point is unable. This more than is unable x, and your cumulative frequency always one value. So the respective point is 50, 100, 55, 98, 60, 90, 65, 78, 70, 54, and 75, 16. So these are the points. Now we are going to plot this one also in the graph shape. So this point is corresponding to more than OG, and this point is corresponding to less than OG. So this one less than OG. Less than OG. And this one more than OG. Right? Now I'm going to draw less than OG in the graph shape. Right? So here, look at the data here. So in the data, the less than OG points 55,2 and 60,10. So like that. So here in the x value, which one maximum? So 8 is the maximum. And also y value, 100 is the maximum. Right? So according to that, I stated the x-axis, y-axis like that, the scale. Okay? So 5, 8, I stated x-axis 135 equal to 5 units. Okay, up to 80. So according to the maximum number. And similarly, y-axis also 100 is the maximum one. Here y-axis also I took 1 centimeter equal to 5 units. So I wrote this case here. So x axis 1 centimeter is 5 units and y axis 1 centimeter is 5 units. Right? Now we are going to plot the points for less than OG. So for less than OG is here. So we have 55,2 and 60,10. So like that. So first the point 55,2. So in x axis 55. So 55. So we have 15 and 55 is here. And 55,2. So here 5. So 2 it may be here. Right? So that is nothing but 55,2. So next next point is nothing but 60,10. So here 60,10. So 60 is here and 10 is here. So this one 60,10. And what is next point? So next point is 65,22. So 65. So 65 is there and the 20 is here and 21 may be here. Okay, approximate accordingly. So 65,22. And the next one 70,46. So 70. So 70 is here. So 46 means so get 40. And 45, so 46 may be here, right? So 70,46. The next one, 75,84, right? 75,84. So 75 is here, and 84, so 8 is here, and 85 is also here, so it will come like this. So here, so 75 comma 84. 75 comma 84. So the final is 75 comma 60. So 75 is here and 15 is here. 15 is here. So 16 may be just little bit more. That is 16 here. So this point is nothing but 75 comma 16. Now I'm going to connect all the points with the same curve like that. Okay. Without using scale. So it will come so like this.
Look at the students. So here, so after plotting that less than points, I connected all the points with a line. That is that with a curve. That when you are connecting the points with the curve, don't use any scales. Okay, draw by your hand. Right, that is very important. And then here I connected or I plotted that more than ogive points also, and then I connected with the curve. On the same graph sheet, right? But don't use scale while you are connecting all the points.
So that's it. So that is something even more than OG, this one. So more than OG. So this one less than OG. Okay. So that is the procedure to draw less than or more than OG in the graph sheet. Right? Suppose, if you want to find out the median, if you want to find out the median for this region and more than O0, so we can find out the intersection point of the OG scale. So the intersection point of the OG scale is here, it may be here, in this one. Okay? And we have to draw a line corresponding to that point vertically to the x axis. Vertically to the x axis, like this. Okay? So that will be here 70. So your median is nothing but.
Okay, listen here. So after drawing your less than ogive and more than ogive, so they will meet anywhere in the graph, right? From that intersection point, draw a vertical line. Draw a vertical line. So that will meet in your x-axis. So that point, intersection point, is on the x-axis nothing but your median. That also will be the approximate value only, right? So in our question, the last question, that vertical line is maybe meet exactly 70 or nearer to 70, right? So check your calculation with your actual calculation, that is by using the formula also, right? That is the next one. Listen here. So here for example, I drawn here, it is not related to any other questions. Suppose if you are taking this as a less than ogive. Now we are going to find out the median from this without drawing more than ogive means first you have to find out the n value from the data. So n value is nothing but total frequency. So for example, total frequency is 70 and that n by 2 is nothing but 35, right? So in cumulative frequency, that is in the y column, that is in the vertical line, we can find out the 35. So 35 is here. So from here, we can from 35 just draw a horizontal line directly with the scale, okay, directly to the curve. So that will intersect your curve at anywhere. So from that, you can draw one more straight line to the x-axis, okay. So that will intersect your x-axis at anywhere. That intersection point is nothing but your median, right. So this is the same thing for more than frequency also. Suppose if you draw the more than curve like this means, right, now we are going to find out median with that more than curve alone, right? How can you find out? Again, you can calculate the n value and n by 2 value. Suppose for n by 2 value 40 means, so from that 40 you can draw a horizontal line like this that will meet your curve at anywhere, and from that you can draw one more vertical line, so that will meet your x-axis. So that particular point is nothing but your median, right? So that is the procedure to find out median through less than ogive or through more than ogive, but not on the same graph. Okay. So let us continue in the next slide.